Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you how to create this girl animation in PowerPoint 2016. So the first thing first, let me open the selection pane from the home tab by clicking on the select drop down button and then click on selection pane. And here you can see all the objects that I have used in this presentation, and all of the objects has been drawn using the shape tool. And if you want to learn more about shape tool, then you can watch my playlist, and the link of that playlist is given in the description below. So as you can see that I have used three audio files here in this presentation to create the sound effect. Let me show you the slideshow again. So while seeing the slideshow, if you don't want to hear the audio, then you can just turn off the audios by just clicking on this I button in front of the audio files. So if now I will play the slideshow, then you will not hear the audio effects. If you want to download this presentation, then the link of this presentation is given in the description as well. And when you will download this presentation and will open it in PowerPoint 2016, then you will only see the white background. As you can see that as I am turning these objects on, the light 10, light 9 and light 8 and so on, then you will start seeing these white rectangle on top of all the objects. That is because these rectangles has been created to create the lightning effect when the car drive by. So that is why you will not see any object if you open that presentation in PowerPoint. So if you want to work inside this presentation, then I will advise you to turn off these light objects by clicking on the I button. So you can see all the other objects. So let me open the animation pane to show you all the animation that I had applied on this presentation, and we will discuss about them one by one. So first of all, we will talk about the hair pony, that one. So to create the hair pony effect, what I used is the grow shrink effect, and you can apply this effect by clicking on the add animation drop down button and then just click on grow shrink. And I am using with previous for all the animation that you are seeing here in the list. So we have the duration of this animation, half a second. And if you open the effect option properties of this effect, then you can see that I have applied 105% horizontal growth without any smoothness with auto reverse with a duration of 0.5 seconds, that is half a second. And I am repeating this effect until end of the slide. So if I see the slideshow, then you can see that pony is growing and shrinking to 105% rate and then reversing back to its original size. So let me turn on all the objects and see the slideshow again, and let me discuss all the animation that I have applied in this presentation. So the important animations that you have to learn in this presentation are the major four animations. The first one is the hairs. As you can see that these hair has the curve effect, and this smoke has also a curve effect. And you can't apply these curve effects using PowerPoint effects. So that is what the most important thing is in this tutorial. And the next thing is the lightning effect that you see here when the car drive by. And the eyes. You can see that the eye blinking effect is a little more realistic than my previous videos. So that is what we are going to discuss in this tutorial. And these animations are very easy to apply in PowerPoint. So I have mostly applied the flash once effect. So as you can see that on light 1 to light 10, you can see I have applied the flash once effect with a duration of 1 second with a delay timing of 4 seconds when the car drive by. And each lightning effect has a delay timing of 0.10 second. For the third one, you can see that I have applied 4.20, and for the fourth one 4.30. So each lightning effect has a 0.10 second delay. So if I select all these lights and delete these animations, and we will apply these animation from the beginning. So what I am going to do is I am going to hide all these objects and will only show the light. So that is the first light, and here we have a rectangle on top right here, this green rectangle, and I have applied a flash once effect on this rectangle here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to replicate the same animation to this light object using the animation painter. So the easy way to replicate the same animation to various objects is to double click on this animation painter. And now I am going to turn off this flash once rectangle here and going to click on this light one object. So here we have this light one object has the flash once effect. And in PowerPoint, when you apply the animation, then it will automatically start showing you the preview of that particular effect. So if you don't want to see the preview, then you can click on this preview drop down button and uncheck this auto preview option. So to apply the same effect to multiple objects, the easiest way is to, as you can see that I have applied the flash once effect on the light one, and I have to apply the same animation on rest of the 9 objects. So what I am going to do, let me press the escape key to turn off the animation painter and let me reselect this. So as you can see that this light one has the flash once effect. So you have to double click on this animation painter. Now turn off this light one and make the light two visible by clicking on the I button, and then just click on the light two object. And you can do this continuously by hiding one object in a time and showing the another one. That way you can quickly apply the same animation to multiple objects. So when you have a lot of object inside your slide, then the selection pane helps you to do the task easily. So we are going to turn on all the objects again, and you can see that we have this light one effect on all the objects. So the only thing you need to do now is to add the delay timing. So I am going to select light one here and hold down the shift key and then select the light 10, and I want to apply the delay timing to 4 seconds, and then I will add a 0.10 second delay between each effect. So as we have 10 light objects, so I have used a duration of 1 second for each object. And you have to understand the flash once effect, that how it works. So the important thing about the flash once effect is, it doesn't matter that how much duration you are giving to the flash once effect. The important thing about the flash once effect is that it only shows the object for just 0.10 second. Okay, let me show you the slideshow again, and this time I am going to turn on the car drive by sound and turning off the rest of two. So as the car drive by, you can see that all those 10 objects show one by one within a 1 second duration, and each object is showing itself for just 0.10 seconds. And that is what we have done to all the other three animations, that is the hairs, the smoke and the ice. So let me show you them. Let me turn on show all, and here you can see that on the smoke, let me hide these one. So as you can see that smoke here, these are 10 different objects here. And I have applied the same flash once effect on each of the object with a different delay timing. So you can see that these are 13 smoke objects. So let me show you all of them one by one, so you can understand the concept easily. So here is the smoke one, which I have drawn using the shape tool. And after that, I turn off this and show you the second one. And if I show you each of these smoke one by one, then you can see that it is creating the curved smoke effect. So once you have different frame of the same object, then you can show each frame one by one using the flash one effect, and that is what I have done in this presentation. As you can see that on smoke one we have the duration 1.30 second, that is the total duration of for the 13 objects. I mean, I am using 13 different objects to create the smoke effect, so that is why I am using 1.30 second total duration for each object, and we have a delay timing between each object is 0.10 second, and that is the default timing for flash one effect. It will show you the smoke one for just 0.10 second, that is the default behavior, and then it will make it disappear and will show you smoke two and then smoke three, and it will do that continuously within 1.30 second, and that will create that smoke effect. So the same technique has been applied on the hairs as well, and you can see the object list here, and here you can find the hair, hair 10, hair 9, hair 8, and I have used the same technique on the hair, and as you can see that there are 10 different hair frames. So I have used the time duration of 1 second with the 0.10 second delay between each object. So the next thing is the face, and here we have applied the motion path for the eyes. As you can see that for left black eye and the right black eye, I have used the motion path, left motion path, and let me show you the slideshow, and these eyes will make a turn. So the last thing that you need to learn is the face impression, that is the blinking eye effect, and the eyebrows are also moving along with. So I did a mistake here, I should combine the face with the eyebrow, but when I was drawing these objects, I have created these two different objects here. Face is different and the eyebrows are different. And if you want to create this presentation from the beginning, then you can also combine face and eyebrow together, and then you can apply the same animation to just one object, and that will create the same animation for the eyebrows and eyes. So let me hide all these objects and show you the face only, and here we have the six different poses of the face. And if I show you each of them one by one, so here we have face 1, and then we have the face 2, this one, and then we have the face 3, this one. So here you can see that eyes are shrinking a little bit, and if I show you the fourth frame, then you can see that the eyes are totally closed here. And then we have the closed eyes animation, and you will not see until I apply a white background, because those closed eyes are in black color, and here you can see that closed eyes. So let me undo that, and then it shows you the face 5 and then face 6, that is opening the eyes. You can also note down that the eyes brow are also moving along with the face impression, so they are moving a little bit down. And to create that effect, I have applied the different frames and used the flash ones effect on them. So the important last thing that you need to learn in this presentation is that the appear disappear effect. So as you can see that here we have the face 2 and then face 3 and face 4, but on face 4 you can see that I have applied the appear effect instead of flash ones, and there is a reason for that. And if I hide all the objects and turn on the face and eyes only, let me show you. So if I show you the slideshow with the face only, so that is how it is showing you the eye blinking effect by showing you six different frames within a second. So as I was telling you that I have used appear and disappear instead of flash one for a few particular objects, and there is a reason behind that. That is, when I want to show the face 2 and after that face 3 is following, and then for face 4 I have applied the appear effect at 2.70 seconds, and it has always has a auto default duration, and then I want to hide the face one. And it is not possible if you are using flash ones continuously on different objects, then you can't hide a particular object within from using the flash ones effect. So it will make a confusion there. So that is why to hide that particular object, I use the disappear effect. And then I to show the closed eye at a particular point, I am using 2.80 delay timing. And that was not possible if I continue to use flash one effect for that particular object. That is why I have used the appear effect for closed eyes as well. And it is showing you closed eyes at 2.80 second, and then it will disappear, and the closed eyes will get disappear at 2.95 second, and that is 0.15 second delay between both of them, and it is not possible with the flash ones effect. Then I want to hide the face 4 at a particular duration, so I have to use the disappear effect. And then the phase 5 and phase 6 have the same animation, and lastly it will show you the phase 1 at a particular 3.20 seconds. So the important thing about this tutorial was the realistic animations that you can see in hair, eyes and the smoke and the lightning effect, and it is only possible with the flash ones effect with different frames, or you can call different objects. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.